Welcome back to Liquid Lunch. Bill Cortez here filling in for John Tobacco. It's December 29th, and we are in week 41 of 15 days to end the spread. So welcome back. What's interesting is as we move forward into the new year, there have been a lot of talk about a vaccine passport or having to carry a certain vaccination card on you. Let's go to a tweet from Ryan Fournier, who tweeted out, if you don't have your vaccine passport, which we've talked about, in order to travel, if you don't get the vaccine, you'll lose your rights and freedoms. If we let this happen, what's stopping the government from requiring something much worse in the future? Well, it's interesting. This is something that we've heard about for a long time now, and it's certainly been kicked around since the beginning. Dr. Fauci had mentioned something like this early on, and I think it's very clear. If you don't put your foot down now with these things, it's a slippery slope. And we've seen this happen in other cases, too, and in other situations where we've allowed the government to creep in slowly but surely. And what's amazing is that they're not following science, and they're not following data on COVID and on the outbreak and the spread. We saw a report earlier in the week that asymptomatic people are not spreading, are not responsible for the spread of COVID. And it's amazing how proponents of big government, how the Gavin Newsoms and the Andrew Cuomos and the Bill de Blasios of the world are pushing so-called data and science, but they've nitpicked. They don't want to talk about it in its full context and as a whole. And I think we just had a tweet up before talking about the reality of what we're seeing in these studies, that asymptomatic people are not the spreaders that we've been told. So we were told that we have to lock down because restaurants, we're spreading in restaurants. Restaurants account for less than 1%, about 1% of all spread. We were told that you can spread COVID if you're asymptomatic. Studies are showing that that simply is not the case. So over and over again, we see big government politicians nitpick and cherry pick the data that they want to share to enforce their draconian restrictions on people, on small businesses, on restaurants, and on families all across the country, but they don't want to talk about the facts that run contrary to that. And the facts, if we really want to follow science, we really want to follow the facts, then I think things would look very different right now. And I think that's what we're seeing all across the country is people are simply fed up with what's happening. And you can only put up with so much of it until people hit a breaking point, until the $600 or $2,000 stimulus check that they're talking about in Washington evaporates quickly, when rent is due, when utilities are due, when college tuition is due. It's nothing in the grand scheme of things. And I think people need to get back to work. Kids need to get back to school. We are failing an entire generation of kids, and it's hurting low-income kids even worse, which is an absolute travesty of what's happening right now. And the same old that we've seen for the last 9 months simply is not sustainable and not going to last. And I think people, Democrats, Republicans, Independents, people who are not even politically involved, are seeing that just enough is enough. And something has to change here. Something has to change. We could put a man on the moon, but we can't figure out how to get kids to school. I find that a little odd. And I think a lot of people do too. And I think that's the frustration that people have with this, is that the same old that we've seen, the lockdowns, the curfews, the shutdowns, they haven't worked. If you look at the numbers in California, they've had the most stringent restrictions, and yet COVID cases are through the roof. So it's simply not working. And the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. We'll be back. We have some great guests coming up. We'll see you after the break.